So we are in the month of August, and here we have the five best apps that you might probably want to install even before the month of August ends. Let's get into the video. So starting off today, as number one, we have this app called Smart Kate. Smart Kate, as the name suggests, is a very smart app that groups almost every app that you have on your phone into just one simple app. So you can see from here that we have notepad, recorder, dictionary, magnifier, batteries, and a lot of stuffs on this particular app. So if you want to get an app that you don't need to install different apps on your phone, but get one that has been grouped, or that has grouped each and every one of them into one particular app, you might want to give SmartKit a try. It doesn't end at the productivity and utility tools. If you click on the three bars over here, you can access the all-in-one social media handle. So your Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, LinkedIn, Pinterest, Snapchat, Skype, and almost everything has been grouped into one particular app. You don't need to download and add them separately. You can just access them straight out from here, and then you can save a lot of space on your phone. Aside that, you can go to read all your news from the ABC, BBC, CNN, and all the popular news that you can read. You can read them straight from here. You just have to click on any one of them, say BBC, and then it takes you to the BBC platform, and then you can read almost every news out from there. You don't end over there. If you click on the three dots over here, you can also access all your shopping online. So Amazon, Best Buy, eBay, and almost all of the Walmart, even Walmart, we have Walmart, and every online shop or store that you might think of, you might find it in SmartKit. If you want something that you can manage space with, go for SmartKit. Moving on, at number two is Google Podcast. Well, actually, if you are not a fan of podcast, you better start listening to podcast. Podcast is more or less like the audio form of YouTube. So if you like watching videos on YouTube, you probably might want to get to podcast. So Google Podcast is very simple. I love the simplicity of this particular app, where it brings you the top podcast, and then you have the trending post, and it has grouped almost everything to you. So the top podcast in comedy, in politics and news, in sports and recreation, and in education, business, and in technology. So it has grouped them for you. You just have to, or better still, if you have a name, or if you are coming from a popular channel, or a friend that sent you over, you just have to type the name, and then you are good to go. Additionally, you can subscribe to some of the people that you love to listen to. One thing I love about this is, if you don't want, or if you don't have the internet bundle to stay online to listen to it, you can download it right from here by clicking on the download button, and that makes it super simple. So if you are looking for a very simple way to listen to your podcast to kill time, or whilst you're in the traffic, you might give Google Podcast a try. So coming up at number three is Regal Flights and Hotels. If you're somebody that has been traveling even within your country or outside of your country, you might want to give this app a try. It's super helpful. I love how it automatically searches cities and locations using your phone's location. So basically, this one just located that I'm in Accra currently. It pops out the hotels, restaurants, and flights available in the city that you currently have yourself in. Also, it suggests some popular destinations that you can visit, and then some exclusive offers. At Explore here, it can suggest to you the visa-free countries that you can search for. And then if you come back at home here, you can actually book your flights over here. You just have to choose your departure, select the departure date, and select the return date, and the number of passengers, whether it's an economy or a MasterCard. Just input in all those informations, and then you're good to go. Also, for hotels, it can just search for hotels available for you. So you pick your destination, and then your check-in date, your check-out date, and then the number of people you are looking, or the number of people in the room that you are looking for. This is a very simple app to use. It includes a Google map that you can use to trace these locations once you book for that particular place. So I think this is a very good app for the travelers out there. You might want to give it a try. Coming up at number four today is the expense manager. Yeah, this is a very simple, very neat app that helps you to manage your expenses. It comes with the income, expenditure, all transactions and reports. So basically just four things on the screen over here, but then it's super awesome. This is how it works. You just add your income to your total income of the month. Let's assume this is your budget. So you input in your income, and then for every expense that you make, you're just going to input it also. So the amount here allows you to input in the month, and then the category here helps you to categorize it to drinks, food, clothing, transportation, fuel and other stuffs. Also, you can set in a date and then the time, and then the cash mode. So as you input in your income and expenditure, it automatically deducts the expense from the income, and then it gives you your balance over there. Also, when it comes to the all transaction over here, you are able to trace your transaction, so all that is spent on, you can actually trace it back. And then the reports over here gives you a summary of all that you've been doing over. So you can view by type, or you can view by category. So let's say this is the category, this is what you've spent on fuel, food, transport, and then on business. So it's very simple and very interesting to use. You have to keep notice of your expenses, so anytime you're out there and you buy something, you can just quickly go to the expenses and then you input in that one to keep track of all that you are spending on. So last on the list today is this particular app called Clue. So Clue is basically for the ladies out there. It helps you to keep track of your period, your menstrual period, and all those things that you need to do. It's very simple to use. Just have to input in your date of when your last period started, and then it keeps track of all these days. So the gray part here represents your free days, and here is your fertile window, and here is the period window. It is very simple to use. If you come at the settings over here, you're able to read about the Clue encyclopedia. It gives you the period, the fertile window, and all that you need to know about this app. Also, you can input in a lot of stuff when you come here. So this is your calendar that you can trace everything. So add your mood, how you're feeling, how the bleeding was, and everything per day. So you just have to select, and then you can take whether it was light, medium, heavy or sporting. So this app is very nice for all the ladies out there. You can learn a lot about your periods and all those stuff. I've had a couple of lady friends to try this out and tested it, and they've come to report that it is very nice and it's been very helpful. So you can get this app and try it out and let me know about what you think about this app. So guys, that's it. Those are the top 5 apps that I tried for this month so far. Thank you so much for sticking around and watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Innocent here, and bye.